Hi guys, welcome to Prince Astrology, your one-stop astro channel, and I'm back in the nature. And this video is very special because today Sun made its transit to the sign of Sagittarius. Sun was in Gandanta and Sun made a transit in the sign of Sagittarius. And why this is important, why this is very much crucial for our life, we will discuss in detail. And but before that, do not forget to hit like, subscribe and share, and hit the bell icon so that you never miss another update. So Sun, which is the planet of soul, the Atma, has made its transit 5th from Leo, that means 5th from his own zodiac in the sign of Sagittarius. Now you have to understand that there are crucial inputs that this Sun is going to give us for the next 1 month. That means till the Makar Sankranti or the transit of Saturn to Capricorn. From now onwards, Sun is going on a cleansing process. But through fire. Understand, Sagittarius is fire. Sun is a fiery planet. It's a ball of fire. While it goes in Sagittarius, it is in full inflammation. Because Sun is in full inflammation, the soul is very enlightening. The soul is very strong. And the soul has the potential to give you more than what you can even think from yourself. Because soul is within you. Soul is you. So you are going to undergo tremendous amount of, I would say, rejuvenation, reincarnation. I won't say transformation this time because this is reincarnation. Now, also one point, Saturn, Jupiter and Ketu, three highly spiritual planets, are already present in the sign of Sagittarius. Sun will go and will join them. Jupiter is already in his own abode in the Sagittarius. Sun goes there. Saturn and Ketu, karma, dharma, atma, moksha, all are together in the house of dharma. That means the dharmic interpretation of your soul will come into picture. So you will understand the dharma of your life. So you will understand what you are born for. You will understand what you are made for, what you are there in this world for. The purpose of the life is now going to decode itself, not for everybody, but for few. It will be a remarkable journey for next 1 month. What more remarkable is, for which I will make a video tomorrow, that Moon will also go in this same sign of Sagittarius. Mercury will join and there will be a 6-planet conjunction in this house. While the Sun and Moon remain in the sign of Sagittarius, the eclipse formation through Ketu in the sign of Sagittarius will give you a tremendous amount of shedding off the load, giving up the responsibilities that you don't need to follow, that you don't need to obey. Giving up the inhibitions, growing like never before, glowing like never before. This is going to be a very, very, very spiritual, a non-material transformation, a non-material reincarnation of your soul. But this time you will also understand yourself. This 1 month, I would say what you should do is that you should always think about yourself, meditate on your inner self, meditate using the process known as Antar Tratak. And that is going to give you tremendous amount of shift of energy. Also, Sun is 5th from Leo at this point of time. So definitely it is a Bhavat Bhavam principle from his own house. Because Leo is the natural 5th house. So Sun being in the 9th house also shows lot of destiny change, Bhagya Parivartan, and following of Dharma. So this is going to be a very, very powerful and a very, very enlightening transformation. And what the Sun is going to bring is that it will make things very clear. Now this is going to make things clear by filtering out a lot of things, because Saturn, Jupiter and Ketu will filter out the darkness. It will give you the wisdom, it will give you the knowledge, and the combination of Sun and Jupiter is extremely powerful in Sagittarius, combined with the ripping apart of the force that rips apart, that is the karmic force of Saturn and Ketu. You will be ripped apart, your soul will be torn apart into two pieces between the dark and the light, and only the light will remain and the darkness will go away. Yes, you have to go through the pain of being torn apart. You have to go through the pain in which, suppose your dirt was there on your body and you have to scratch it off, so that it may give you some sore, some marks, but that will heal in some time. But what it will ultimately give you is you in a purer form. So you are going to be pure, perfect and rejuvenated. That is what this sun is going to bring in. Also, what you have to identify is, where is the sign Leo in your own zodiac, in your own horoscope? Wherever the sign Leo is, you have to identify the sun will be fifth from that house. So you have to identify where the sign of Leo is placed, the attributes of that house. You have to learn from that attribute. For example, if you're a Sagittarius ascendant, say for an example, the sun will be in the ninth house and the ninth house lord will go into the fifth house. So it will be a Rajyoga formation. This will give you immense capacity and capability to explore your horizon, to expand your horizon, explore your identity and be what you always wanted to be. This time the dharma will expand, and this also shows that you need to learn more about your culture. You need to learn more and you need to educate yourself more about the spiritual practices. So you have to practice a lot of spiritual things, meditation, tantra, whatever you are doing in your own domain, but do it on a sattvic way. Do not do it on a rajasic or tamasic way. This also shows that with every coming morning in the sign of Sagittarius, sun is going to bring in the light and shine on our soul, and therefore giving us an opportunity to go from the darkness to light. So seek the light and give up the darkness. Asato ma sadgamaya, tamso ma jyotirgamaya, mrityur ma amritam gamaya. Om shantihi 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 is the mantra that you need to practice every day, maybe 11 or 21 times when you get up early in the morning. If you are able to do it, you should do Surya Namaskar, because Surya Namaskar along with Surya Mantra is going to be extremely helpful, not only for the body but also for the mind. While sun is going, sun also defines health. So when sun is moving in this house with Saturn, Jupiter and Ketu, what may happen is that your health may get a slight impact. So you need to take care about the nutrition, you need to take care about your health. But yes, if you are determined, if you know what you're doing, you will be able to walk through all the phases of life without any hint of or a hint of doubt. What you have to do is believe in yourself in this 1 month and try to rejuvenate and transform your soul, not your body, not your mind, but your soul for the first time. And therefore you have to understand, at least try to understand yourself. Maybe you can make a video about yourself, then watch it. Maybe you can write about yourself, but this 1 month has to be, who am I? Why am I here on this planet? What am I trying to do and what is my purpose? If there is a problem, then why is there a problem? If you need, you can take definitely a help of a learned astrologer to understand this. I know astrology is a very complicated science and it's not easy for everyone to understand, but the interpretation has to come. If you do not have an astrologer, at least you can meditate and pray to God. If you want to chant Gayatri Mantra, that is also a possible way, but because there are certain rules attached behind it, to some people it is not recommended, for some it is. So I leave that up to you and up to your knowledge on that, but definitely Surya Namaskar is a possibility. Especially for the people who belong to public domain, this is going to be a very life-changing time for them, because they will be represented in a very different way in the public form platform, because sun represents shine and light. So you will give shine and light to everyone, and especially for the doctors, for the healers. For the healers also, this is going to be a tremendous life-changing time for them, because sun will heal them. And through them, a lot of people will get healed. So doctors, healers, Reiki masters, angel therapists, say what? Whatever form of healing you are doing, maybe psychological healing or emotional healing, you will get the power and the courage to heal a lot of people. But you have to fight your internal battle. This sun is going to give a tremendous churning light of scenario inside your heart, because your soul is getting relieved. Your soul is getting scratched off, scraped off the darkness, and this way internally you are being a better and a new person. Now the challenge is whether you will be able to accept it, digest it. Gratitude, sacrifice, letting go of the things and adjusting and recalibrating are the few keywords which is going to be very, very crucial for you. If you are able to do that, if you are able to calibrate yourself, you are able to adjust yourself, this is the right time for the transformation. This is the right time to know who you are, know your capabilities, and then move on with a greater pace, greater sense of comfort, greater sense of confidence. And when Sun transits Saturn, the soul is now, I would say, going into a very practical domain. With Jupiter comes the knowledge, and with Ketu, you will get an opportunity to give up the negativity. So if you are having any addiction, you can give that up very easily. So if you are trying to give up negative things, right now is the time. Just, I would say, do not hesitate, move ahead. God is with you, Sun is with you, planet is with you, and the light and the heat of the solar system is going to give you the opportunity that you were always waiting for. Thank you guys, thank you for watching Puneet's Astrology. I know this may be a spiritual kind of a video, but this transit is definitely far more spiritual than material. So I hope you like the video, and if you like, do not forget to hit like, subscribe and share, and hit the bell icon so that you never miss another update. This is your host Puneet, signing off.